Yo, happy Friday, motherfuckers.
Sharif O'Neal is gonna get some females pregnant.
The Weeknd is back and he's a god, but you already knew that, of course.
The Weeknd is pregnant.
With my baby.
Stark Racial Humor, episode 93. Happy Friday.
Let's jump in.
New Dark Racial. That nature had to hate your player. I'm kicking the door down, never said I'm hater. Straight later, laid the girl like Darth Vader. Made her from Collie Park to Fed, all the way down to the hater. Like Jada, from with shop and Spoldy, that was shawty. Save the snake and eggs in a beam.
What the fuck, Poppy?
But she lost me. My baby mama beat me. 7 o'clock is gonna cost me, but I still want to cut her dope. Maybe she had to work.
My man.
Women a real tight skirt. She was fine as what? I wanted to sex the girl up. She said, let's hit the parking lot so I can sick your duck. I say, cool. I
really wanted to cut you, but this will do. I got to pick
up my daughter, plus my baby mama beat me too. She said she understood and everything was kosher. I gave her a little whiskey and a lovely poster. It's like that now. He's like that now. You better go get the
damn. J. Cole uses a lot of other people's beats.
It's about 4 5 cats off in my leg now. I think a lot of people have these. I think this is also kind of like a sample of some sort of brick song.
It's like that now. It's like that now.
Stark Racial Humor, motherfuckers.
What up, guys? Happy Friday morning, night, afternoon. What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the show. Dark Racial Humor, free flowing, end up conversation about whatever's appropriate at the time. I'm Bon Jen.
Call John David Ricker. It's 12/5. That's December 5th, 2019, is when this was recorded. You're listening it. Whenever you're listening to it, but you're listening it at the best time.
The best time.
This is the best episode of Dark Racial Humor. Nothing like those fuckers at Robin Hood Snacks Daily. Fuck you, Nick and Jack.
And also the last episode, so enjoy it.
You know, sometimes good things have to come to an end, and you're seeing the end.
Yep. So, yeah, later.
That's it.
That's it. That's it.
New Dark Racial.
Last Dark Racial.
Clocking out for the weekend.
This is the $47 billion exit. We talked about it last episode on episode 92, and we did it. We sold Disney's Dark Racial Humor to Tesla.
It was a hard sell, but they finally budged.
I said, nothing over $47 billion. And they were like, no, please, we want to give you the $50 billion, $130 billion. I'm like, ah.
I won't get out of the bed for less than $47 billion. Yeah,
I don't go to sleep unless I get money.
We have a live studio audience today. It's Alex the Cat just sitting here. Chilling with us here at Adobe House.
This is Adobe
Studios
House.
Media Production, Lot C in L.A. You know, or you already know the fucking vibes.
It used to be owned by someone else who didn't like us throwing parties loudly and peeing on apartment complex. But we bought it from them, Todd.
What's that fucking Drake line? Fuck.
It started from the bottom. Now we're here.
No, it's like complain Ooh. About the noise. I'm going to buy that motherfucker or some shit.
Yeah, I'll buy it.
Buy that motherfucker.
I'm going to buy Todd's apartment.
Shout out Drake. We know he's an avid listener to the pod, the PC.
Thanks. What's PC? Podcast.
Yeah.
You can join us live at adobehouse.live on Twitter, hashtag DRH. If you think Bon Jen's a bum, type in hashtag DRH. And then after, say Bon Jen bum, hashtag DRH. If you think he's not a bum, Bon Jen not a bum.
Let me have it. Let me know, because my existence is dictated by you guys.
At BON_JENN.
100%.
Don't really like underscores. That's why mine is at Caller John. That's two L's and an H.
I tried to get Bon Jen one word, but some motherfucker took that shit.
You got to take it. You got to have ownership of your name.
Motherfucker, that shit was made in 2007. I wasn't even born yet.
I was born in 2004.
Oh, God. So you're what?
Six?
15? Is that how that works?
Matt? Legal. If you're 15, I'm 15.
Oh, shit. Okay. What's up, everybody? I have some great news. Dude. It's going to rain this weekend in L.A., so damn. I don't have to go to work. Yay.
I have to go to work tomorrow, dude. I usually have a 4-day week. Got to go in tomorrow.
Aww.
Probably do not a lot, but I'll be on that Facebook shit just businessing it up.
I also have to go to work tomorrow. Probably going to be sick at the office, but, you know, so much drama at my job. Just store drama.
Dude. What's going on? No, dude.
I'm
really
not
going to
say their real names, but Alex and Kevin are just being super petty.
Ugh.
I'm just like, yo, you guys are some motherfucking teenage girls right now.
Dude, what are they doing?
They just gossip about each other to me when each other's not there. And it's the stupidest shit, dude. Like, Alex will do he'll do two pull-ups. It'll be like two more than Kevin. I'm like, bro, you're 35.
You guys have a pull-up bar?
It's like a truss, like a lighting.
A trust fall?
No, it's you know those metal things on fucking stages? Mm-hmm. They're called trusses. Sometimes we do pull-ups on them.
Yeah, you got to.
Yeah, and I'm just like, dude, I don't care about your bullshit. I mean, they're fucking mad at each other because one guy's lazy, the other guy has to pick up the slack, and vice versa, and it's just like...
Wait, so they're both lazy?
It's not that... Okay, it's just, like, they just make mistakes that affects the other person.
Just all the time?
Yeah. And
it's
like,
a real yin-yang situation.
It's like, yo, why don't you guys fucking sit down and just talk?
And every problem is a communication problem.
Just be fucking adults and stop fucking sending all this shade in the group chat. I don't give a fuck
group
about
chat.
Your problems.
Unless you have AIDS. AIDS, I don't think, is a communication problem. Unless you get AIDS from somebody that didn't communicate it.
AIDS is the ultimate form of communication, I guess, because you got to have sex to have AIDS.
Yeah. I mean,
and sex itself is kind of like communication.
Yeah, sure.
Just
it's
exchanging energies, exchanging.
Ooh, all right, moon.
Yeah.
All right.
You know.
Right, drip or
just
drop.
Busting in that shit. Yeah, so that's what I got to deal with tomorrow.
Is that your day? Dude? How was your day today, though?
Today, it was just fucking, I walk into work and I got to get in, get out because I got to go do this fucking setup for an event. Mm-hmm. And homeboy, like, I don't know. I said, what's up to homeboy? And then I come back and his friend's like, yo, dude, you fucking mad at, I don't know. I don't know why they think I'm mad. I'm just like, yo, you fucking mad at Alex? I'm just dude, no.
Most workplaces just like fucking school?
It's all politics.
But
doesn't matter.
Like school?
Yes. It doesn't matter where you work. Doesn't matter if you work at Disney or if you work at McDonald's. The fact that you see people 40 hours a week, every day, shit's going to brew. Like, it doesn't matter. So, you just got to accept that, I guess, in life. Even my dad, about to retire in a couple years, complains about the knuckleheads he works with. So, I'm just like, all right, I still got
What number fire station does he work at?
He doesn't work at a fire station anymore.
Dude, of course not, dude. He's fucking above it.
He works for the city now.
Hey.
So,
working
yeah, that's...
Working for the city.
New dog racial.
That's my, and all these motherfuckers at my job are so stressed, so fucking stressed. I'm just like, yo, dude, maybe do some yoga, maybe work out, but you know,
I suggest meditation.
I'd rather play video games. All right, to each their own, I guess.
To relax, you get just an absorbing amount of flashing lights and sounds to your head.
I think video games are a waste of time, for the record.
I mean, yeah, but a lot of things are a waste of time.
Yeah, I mean, unless you're making money on the video games.
You seen my boy, bro? It's ZX4 or it's XC4. You seen him?
Bart, get this dirty cat off the table, please.
You seen him, bro?
Yeah, Zach. Terrible username, by the way.
It's XC4. It's XZ4. It's pretty cool. I like it.
Could have been like, I don't know, Zach Attack or something.
Zach Attack?
Something. He could have just gone the ninja route and just called himself Sync or something.
Sync. Whoa.
Because if he blows up, then he owns that shit, like Future.
Yeah. Damn.
Future, type in Future on Google, Future's the first guy that comes up.
If I type in Ninja?
Type in Ninja, he's definitely the first guy.
Typing in Ninja, and he's the guy.
Yep.
How old is he? He's 28. It's pretty fucking old. Doesn't look that old.
Yeah, I don't know how long he's been doing it.
I mean, he's probably been playing video games his whole life.
Probably.
I can almost guarantee he had a vlogging channel at one point.
Probably was a Viner.
I can almost guarantee it.
Probably didn't pop off till he changed his hair color. Sometimes that's all you need, you know. Shout out
just
Ninja.
The shortest, littlest thing.
He was on that show, The Masked Singer.
Oh, word.
Oh, my God. I mean, I don't watch it, but I see billboards for it all the time. And I'm just like, dude, Hollywood is too much money, too few ideas.
Too few ideas?
Yeah.
They're scared of the ideas. They have ideas, probably a brewing, but there's people that are like, that's not going to make money, and we don't want to do it.
My mom enjoys that show. Shout out, Mom.
It's also, I think Hollywood is just fucking advertising to the masses like that.
That's all it is.
It's really for people who are like trying to shut off their brain a little bit.
It's like, welcome to the Pepsi halftime show. It's like everything is just brands. Brands control everything. How was your day, though?
Dude,
this is Adobe House.
I got to work. Fucking close my eyes. It's 5 o'clock, dude.
Wow, I wish it were that easy for me. I wish I could take Xanax at work. I gotta drive and shit.
I fucking put the UPS boxes that were supposed to go out yesterday, made sure they went out today. I actually didn't really make sure. Homie fucking Abner kind of pushed that shit out. And I was like, all right. I now don't wait for the... Because UPS guy, homie, has a... His name's Adrian. Let's just fucking make everyday characters here. Adrian, what's going on? Dude, if Adrian listens to my... Dude, I should tell him about the pod, bro.
You should. I tell everyone about the pod. I tell everyone I gossip about the pod, because I know they're not going to listen.
They should.
I can tell... I talk mad shit about my coworkers. Hey, man, you hear the pod? Oh, I'll check it out next week. Okay, dude. Talk mad shit again. Hey, man, you listen to the pod? Nope.
Well, in a couple years, they're going to be like, oh, shit, this million episode, billion dollar pod... That is now augmented and virtual somehow. Okay, what is a future pod? What is it? The 10 years from... What was podcast 10 years ago? The radio?
The radio.
10 years ago was 2009 audio. Was there live streaming at all?
Yeah, but not like it is now.
I remember Rogan had a really early podcast. He was just on Justin TV, which is now Twitch.
Twitch.
And he was just fucking doing the thing. That was kind of that. So what is podcasting 10 years from now?
Probably won't change much. Probably going to be more corporate.
More corporate.
More less. Dark. More like, you know how YouTube.
It's pretty corporate now.
You know how YouTube is like
really
just
programmed.
Straight fucking brands and commercials and just money.
Now?
Yes.
I don't dive into YouTube that hard anymore.
Because of that reason. They ruined it. That's podcasting. There's going to be a couple top guys, and then it's just going to be dominated by fucking Apple or Spotify, whoever tries to get into it. I think fucking Apple should just say fuck it and just buy Spotify.
Shit.
That would literally... Then they don't have to do anything. They just have to just call it Apple Music.
Yeah.
Just get rid of their shitty fucking Apple Music product.
I don't like Apple Music.
Those Spotify things wrapped up.
Oof.
Annoying as fuck.
You don't like them?
I don't give a shit about people's music taste.
Everybody loves it, dude.
Personally. I like it for yourself.
Yeah.
For yourself. But every story, dude, every story is fucking that shit.
Yeah.
It's like, dude. I
love seeing it. And also the Spotify... thing of like playlisting all that shit, because you can hear what you played in fucking 2019 summer. They broke it down in seasons.
That's cool. My Spotify account's not that old, so I don't get that.
Dude, 2011, my Spotify.
Really?
Yeah.
When did I started using Spotify a while ago, but my account's kind of new.
Like I saw what I was listening to heavy in 2011, and I love that shit, bro. Oh, I loved it.
Oh, I used Spotify the day it came to America, I remember. My friend was like, hey, dude, it's free iTunes.
Oof.
I was like, yeah, fucking right.
What do you think is the best way to hear about new technology now?
Probably.
Burgeoning.
The best way to hear about new technology is probably just from your friends.
Adobe House.
Processing power.
Burgeon.
Burgeon.
Burgeon is. Burgeon. To begin to grow or increase rapidly. Flourish. We should look up a word every podcast.
Like the podcasting industry is just flourishing.
Yes.
Either that or it's just like
the lady from
digging
Spotify
itself in a hole
said she doesn't think we're peak podcast.
Oh, definitely not. No. Definitely not. Not until every man, woman, and child has a pod of their own.
Oh, man. Everybody has a podcast.
Everybody don't need a podcast, man.
Except for Bart. Still waiting for his pod.
He just likes to be the middleman. He just likes money. He doesn't give a shit about opinions. He doesn't give a shit about content. He just wants the bottom line. Fuck that top line. And fuck the thing in the middle.
He just wants everyone to be happy. Right, Bart?
Bart meditates with me at 6:30.
I want a Miles Morrow podcast. Shout out Miles Morrow.
I told him, where are those characters, my guy? And he said, ask me when I'm sober.
Ask me when I'm not at my Chrissy's house.
I didn't know her name, bro. Dude. I don't pay attention to chicks' names. They're the homies' chicks.
I'm about to go actually hang out with Miles after this podcast for the first time in years. Haven't seen him in years.
If you don't come back with a character or a storyline, you failed.
Okay.
I need a Morrow character. He also needs to be at that goddamn 8:30. Is he still going to AA every Sunday?
No.
No?
No.
It's fucking Court of Naples.
Bro. Hey. What do you want me to do?
The
grown ass men living in this house, bro. Can't be everyone's dad.
The people, the person you hear right here, every fucking drop. Just the best drops. With John. And of course,
that new dark racial.
The newest
is the man himself, the mind behind just millions of intellectual properties, Miles Morrow.
The reason we do what we do.
I get up in the morning. I think, what would Miles do? And he would get up, make characters, make content.
There's no bigger fear of mine than disappointing Miles. If I disappoint Miles, I have to kill myself.
Yeah, yeah. I have a calendar that says Monday.
What would Miles do today?
Monday, do what Miles does. Tuesday, do what Miles does. Wednesday, think about what Miles would do. And do that today.
What would Miles want for me as a person?
As a person, just solid content and good storylines and a great arc.
We're doing it. We're trying. We're pushing for it.
Hey, listen. Snacks daily? Go fuck yourself.
Hey, if I were you...
You're not going to get no snack facts from me.
Go fuck yourself. I haven't listened to you guys in a minute, but I know you guys are still kicking
it. They rock it every fucking day, bro.
Every day?
5 days a week.
Wow.
They're killing it with business news. They have a great team.
Oh, business news.
Yep. Stop.
That's what it is now?
Robinhood Snacks Daily?
Oh, I thought you were talking about if I were you.
If I were you? No. I didn't even hear you say that.
Oh.
I don't listen to those schmojos.
Those schmucks, dude.
Jake and Amir? Go fuck yourselves.
Shout out to Steve Jobs.
Dead.
The true godfather of podcasting.
Did he podcast? Did he pod hard?
He invented podcasting.
The name for sure. And also podcasting.
I don't
But
I
did
don't,
he pod hard?
I don't think he did a single pod ever.
God damn. Yeah. He didn't know.
He didn't know what it would he become. Didn't know. And it really didn't pop off until like years after it was
fucking
conceived.
I think
really didn't pop
Rogan
off until
did it.
The internet was on.
You know?
Well,
who else popped off podcasting?
New York Times.
With what?
The Daily.
I don't listen to The Daily.
A lot of people do, actually. Most people in the world.
Most people in the world?
They're number one, he's number two.
You know who's number one on Spotify? Besides dark racial humor?
Joe Budden.
The books
are cooked. The books? The
books
are cooked. They say, hey, sign this deal, 10 years, once a week. You can't make podcasts twice a week. You can't make podcasts for any other platform, and we'll magically make you number one.
I don't know, dude. Spotify, some ethical motherfuckers.
If Joe Rogan were placed on Spotify,
he'd be number one.
He'd be number one.
But I think he's also like a goddamn number one, pretty close.
He's Still though, more people listen to podcasts on Apple than Spotify.
I feel like just.
What are the
market share of fucking Apple users to like Apple Music to Spotify?
I know that Spotify has more users, but Apple Music has more paying subscribers. It's something like that. Something like that.
Not a lot of people are subscribed premium on Spotify.
Yeah, there's a lot of free Spotify users that are just...
Isn't Apple Music not free? You can't use it if you don't have it?
There's a free trial. Yeah. But, like, you can't, like... There's no ad-supported version of Apple Music.
Man.
Apple Music needs to fucking step it the fuck up, dude. Like,
I think fucking just Spotify needs to step up these podcast stats. Dude.
Apple Music, you're wasting your fucking money on this bullshit no one gives a fuck about.
What are they spending it on?
They have this shit. Let me go into this Apple Music shit, dude. They have these, like, radio shows, I feel like, that, like, no one... I never hear talk about them.
The Zane Lowe show, I was watching a video on someone's iPhone, and yeah. I really liked it.
Oh, it's good, but it's just, like, no one knows about it.
Yeah.
They have the money to hire whoever they want to make quality content, but it's just, like, dude, I don't know. There's something about them. It just seems less user-friendly.
Apple. For sure.
Yeah.
Yeah, Spotify is good fucking user. What's UX stand for? Design?
Yes.
Why is there an interface? Why is there an X?
I don't know.
It's good.
Damn, Camila Cabello is hot.
Should we have used Libsyn? Is Libsyn not free?
Libsyn as our podcasting platform?
They got data, bro.
I don't know. We can look into that. You ever heard of Up Next, Apple Music?
Nope.
It's a series where they promote an artist for a month, and everyone they've promoted... has blown the fuck up. I don't know because of them or because they have some insider fucking shit, but they had fucking Khalid on there. They had Six Lack on there. They had Bad Bunny on there. They have this fucking beautiful creature named Jesse Reyes on there. Don't like her voice or her music, but she's fine.
Dude, this podcaster's Spotify for podcasters is a...
Podify?
No, it's the same thing for, like, Spotify for artists, but it's for podcasters.
Podding.
They also have a rap, if you want to rap your pod.
Oh, podrap.com, yeah. Today's sponsor. You know what? Speaking of sponsor, we're going to jump into our sponsor. We'll be right back. Yo. Your Los Angeles Clippers Spirit Dance Team.
Man, I went to... Did I talk about the Clippers game, bro?
How was that?
It was okay. I don't think any basketball game for me is going to be super fun unless it's a Warriors game.
Really? So you just watch them lose?
The Warriors?
Yeah.
Dude, I can... Almost a Warriors game this year of 2019, the worst Warriors in maybe a half a decade, is more fun than a Clippers game.
Really? I disagree.
But the Warriors fans are fucking dope, dude.
Any game where I'm just watching my team get fucking taken out like a piece of garbage is a waste of money and time to me. I like it when they're just neck and neck. I don't care how fucking good they were.
It's also just like regular season basketball, man.
Well, you know what? They better step it up because playoffs are tomorrow. And I don't know. Maybe Steph should just stop fucking around.
Welcome back to dark racial humor, in-depth, free-flowing conversation about whatever's appropriate at the time. It's the second trimester of the most award-winningest show in the history of the universe. This podcast has got more money than a talking dog.
This is Adobe House with dark racial humor.
And we have the biggest news of the day. I cannot wait to talk about this. Justin Timberlake issues a apology for holding another woman's hand on set.
Wait, is he married?
Yeah, he's married to Jessica Biel.
Dude, and, Justin Timberlake is pretty squeaky clean.
Justin, yeah, he's
done good.
Never in the fucking media.
Always smiling.
Focusing on his shit. Always showered. Always well groomed.
It's just fucking always got the curls.
Damn. Oh God, I just fucking read this. Headline, Post Malone, I just tested positive for real diamonds. And what? I was like, oh, dude, I thought he had AIDS or something, but nah.
That's funny.
No, so, yeah, he
dude,
was
look
on
at Justin Timberlake, bro. He's just like a wholesome, smiling boy.
He was on set. He's filming a movie, and someone photographed him holding hands with his co-star, and he said, I'm sorry, I was drunk. We didn't do anything. It was wrong. I apologize to my beautiful wife, Jessica. This is not the way I want to live life for my son.
Bro, JT, March 10th at Staples on Barker. Are you in?
Oh, really? I've seen Justin Timberlake before.
It's probably good.
He's pretty good. It was him and Jay-Z.
Jay-Z. You heard what he did?
He actually cheated on his wife.
No, not that. No what? One cares about that.
He turned 50?
No. He put all of his fucking music on Spotify.
Oh, well, fucking adapt or die, you old motherfucker.
That obviously means title wasn't winning.
I saw that coming. Like, when he took it off.
Do you know how good it is to type in Jay-Z and not just see the Linkin Park remixes?
Wait, was it only on... it wasn't on Apple Music or anything?
I think it was just title. Did you know really? Fucking Eminem is a part owner of Spotify?
Is
or
he?
An executive or something?
Good for him.
Yeah, I saw that shit, and I was like, oh, shit, Marshall?
Good for him. Spotify is like the Uber of companies.
Tell them.
It's what you would call a unicorn.
Oh, I've heard Jack and Nick say that over at goddamn Robin Hood Snacks Daily.
A company that is incredibly overvalued.
Yes.
Because it's not making any money.
No.
But the potential is there. So it's just a waiting game at this point?
Dude, I watched a little bit of a NASA broadcasted SpaceX launch today.
Yeah.
And it seemed to have worked.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
NASA. SpaceX.
Yeah. A SpaceX rocket broadcasted by NASA. I'm sure NASA's somewhat like in cahoots with SpaceX.
Right,
I think like you have to be if you're like an American space joint.
Why can't we do what you're doing?
NASA.
why can't our rockets go up and shit? Why can't the public sector do what the private sector is doing?
Why not?
Because you don't have Elon.
Word.
And I don't know. Maybe they just don't have enough money.
I feel. Yeah. I guess they're kind of capped by the gov.
Could be, or they just suck. But no, you know that's
I'm sure that there's probably a comparable valuable engineers at SpaceX as there is as NASA.
Hey, you if you're not good enough for SpaceX, you go to NASA. Elon Musk said this: if you're not good enough for Tesla, you go to Apple.
Yeah. Shit.
Can you believe that? Imagine not being good enough for Tesla, so you have to work at Apple. Oh shit.
I mean, it's all relative, you know.
My wife's gonna leave me because I lost my job at Tesla and now I have to work at Apple.
Is Eminem not, was I lying? I swear I saw his white face somewhere.
Is Spotify a publicly traded company?
Yes, it is.
How much is it worth?
It's about
$1.
No, 100. Like maybe 130 or something. That's I am going in.
Incredibly overvalued.
Going in.
That's incredibly overvalued.
Going in.
Uber's $28.
Is it?
Are you shitting me?
I really like Spotify.
Oh my God.
It's a little emotion driven.
How is a company that loses millions of dollars a year, tens of millions of dollars, maybe more, worth
that
much?
Dude, a lot of bets.
It's like, dude, the music in it is.
But they're not trying to be music. They're trying to be audio destination, just like Uber is trying to be your fucking daily transportation or whatever.
Yeah, but I mean, the core of Spotify is music.
Right now.
So it's like, I don't know. They just abolish the record labels and Spotify will be fine.
Oof. Because you know they make no money on that shit.
Yeah, that's the all their money goes to paying the record labels. And
what if a fucking streaming service made a fucking label?
Well, they could.
Or like a union of some sorts.
They could. I don't know why they do. I think it's because, I think I read this somewhere, they don't want to do that. They just want, they don't want any labels. They just want people to make their own shit and be able to make money from it.
Yeah, cut out the middlemen. But
it's pretty difficult.
But the big boys got the labels.
It's pretty difficult. Now people are just making albums as an excuse to go on tour.
Yeah.
Whereas before, they went on tour kind of for leisure. Because the music was actually making the money.
Yeah, sure.
But now it's just like, fuck, dude, we got to go on tour, bro. Fuck, dude, we got to go on tour.
That's the music money, dude.
Oh, yeah. I wonder how it'll be in the future.
Well, let's think a little bit.
What could be more convenient than streaming?
What's more convenient than streaming? So before... What was the most convenient thing before streaming was?
For music?
Yeah.
I guess the radio?
I was going to say CDs.
Yeah, but you still got to go.
First radio.
You still got to go buy a CD.
But then it's yours and you can listen to it whenever.
Yeah.
Radio, you don't control what's being played.
Yeah.
And it's not portable.
Damn, people used to fucking work to listen to music.
Yeah.
They used to put in that work. And now it's just like,
so bloop. You went, so CDs, and then it was internet downloads, iTunes and LimeWire.
Internet downloads.
Napster.
Thank you, Steve Jobs. A pioneer, a god.
Napster turned into streaming. And that was easier because you didn't have to fucking go through goddamn :CPC shit to download and sync.
I remember Steve Jobs said streaming music will never be a thing because people prefer to own their music. He was wrong.
Sure, sure. But yeah, I'm sure he said it with the most confidence.
He said a lot of wrong things with confidence.
Well, you got to do that.
But he's Steve, so, you know.
Dead.
Our fearless leader.
All
that smarts and still cancer got him. Shit.
That's the good shit.
Rest in peace, Steve.
That motherfucker put his hand on Iger and said, Bob, I got cancer.
Bob, I know you're about to tell everyone about this huge, huge deal, but I got the cancer.
He said he didn't want to do it because he had cancer, right?
Steve Jobs didn't want to do it?
Yeah, that's what he was telling them.
He said that I want you to make the decision whether you think this is a good idea or not.
I thought he was saying, I don't think we should do it because I got cancer. Or he was like, maybe you shouldn't do it because I'm going to be dead soon.
He was kind of saying, I'm about to be the largest stakeholder in Disney, and I'm going to be dead in 5 years. So it's on you, bro.
Dude, I need that clip recreated. Oh, God. I need some solid actors who can.
No one can do Steve, dude. Ashton Kutcher tried.
Oh, he did a bad job.
Michael Fassbender tried.
You think maybe the guy who does method acting?
Who, Daniel Day-Lewis?
Yeah, I don't know.
Maybe. Leonardo DiCaprio was in talks to do a Steve Jobs movie, but then he was like, nah. Like, he doesn't look like Steve Jobs,
no.
But it's Leo, dude. He can fucking do anything. He could play me.
Win an Oscar.
He doesn't have an Oscar?
I think he does now, maybe, for the fucking Bear movie.
Wow. That's trash. That just lets you know that the Oscars is trash, dude.
All of those fucking Hollywood awards.
First Kevin Hart, then this. Oscars stay trash.
My name's Oscar. Been trash.
Remember that Kevin Hart thing, dude?
I just saw a Kevin Hart.
Was that last year?
Commercial banner for Chase, a card, something.
Whoa, Chase homophobic?
Is it?
Supporting a homophobe like Kevin Hart?
Is he a homophobe?
No, he's not.
Oh, shit. Little Brother interview on Real 92.3.
Kevin Hart almost died.
Good, bro. Good riddance.
Wow.
Deserves it.
No, he's cool. He's chill.
Deserves to be dead.
Oh, I don't know about that.
His son doesn't deserve a father.
Oh, that's a little harsh.
Wife?
Oh.
Divorced? No. Glad her ex is dead.
He cheated on her, but they're still together because, you know, money, comfort of living.
Man, Kevin Hart.
Kevy.
I never really liked any of his stand-up.
I don't like his... I like his early stand-up, but now he's super family-friendly. His acting is like...
Very
I like his acting because you can tell that it's him. He adds the Kevin Hart, like, fucking flow to it, you know?
Weird. He has his own cadence. Yeah. He's always very him in any role he is, whether, like, comedy or acting.
Yeah. Even if he's playing a serious role.
Yeah.
With fucking that guy that was
Brandon
in a wheelchair.
Well,
yeah.
What?
What's his name?
What was the wheelchair movie?
He was in the... Fucking, what's that guy's name? The Upside.
The Upside?
He played... He was... What's that guy's name in Breaking Bad?
I don't know his name.
Bryan Cranston.
Yes, it is.
Was a billionaire.
Dude, this looks like an okay movie.
He was a billionaire, but he had a, like, I don't know what disease. Some wheelchair disease. And
dude, I can't. Oh, dude, I remember these.
Kevin Hart was his. I haven't seen it.
I feel like it looks good.
It's Oscar bait.
Mm. I feel like it's good. Is that Kevin? Oh, that does not look like... It looks like fucking Kanye West, bro.
Oh, no. Dude, that was the thing. The poster is not him.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah. They do that a lot in Hollywood. They use different people.
That guy... See, that guy looks cooler. Is Bryan Cranston... That looks like Bryan Cranston a little bit.
Yeah, Bryan Cranston has a less busy schedule, probably, than Kevin Hart.
See, I
the
feel
the hardest
like
working man in Hollywood.
The dude in the poster... Because Kevin Hart, bro... He's branded so well that whenever you see him, you just see Kevin Hart, and you can't, like, have the disbelief of going into it and seeing this as another character.
He can't play another character. Same thing with The Rock.
Word.
The Rock is the most paid guy in Hollywood, and he's the same character in every movie.
I think that's a thing for, like, action characters, but Kevin Hart isn't action.
Kevin
Maybe
Hart
comedy too.
Is just famous for being
no,
Kevin Hart.
Some comedians... do characters and shit. Yeah. Kevin Hart is fucking just his brand.
Some characters, you just throw them in and they can't escape them. Like, Donald Glover will always be Donald Glover. He will never be Lando Calrissian.
I haven't seen that.
He will always be Donnie G.
Donnie G.
Unless he turns into Childish Gambino. Then he's Childish Gambino.
See, that's what I'm saying. I think, well, bro, he was in Community.
Yeah.
That was before he was big.
That was before he was big. No one knew him as Donald Glover, though. Yeah. People barely knew him as Childish Gambino. Fuck
yeah,
him.
Yeah, yeah.
That's crazy. His career astounds the fuck out of me.
Mm.
The fact that you can do comedy and acting and have a successful music career.
Yeah.
Someone else did that. Who was it? Fucking Jamie Foxx.
Jamie Foxx.
Jamie Foxx does that, too.
Dude, he came out at Coachella or whatever one time.
Yeah.
Said, my name's Jamie, my last name is Fox, my middle name is motherfucking. Say it with me. Jamie, motherfucking Fox.
Jamie Fox,
motherfucking Fox.
Is an entertainer.
Jamie,
and Donald Glover is an artist.
Sure. Which one pays more?
Which one makes more money right now? That's a good question. That's a good question. I don't know. I want to say Donald Glover because he has more his hand in more things.
Well, I was saying just like in general, like an artist or an entertainer.
Oh, what makes more money?
Yeah. With
definitely an entertainer.
Yeah.
100%. If you're a famous artist and you're fucking making it as an artist, you're lucky. You're in the minority. If you're Lady Gaga, because Lady Gaga's an artist.
Yeah.
Versus, I don't know. Who's a
Frank
fucking
Ocean?
Entertainer?
Oh, no, no, no.
I would say Frank Ocean's an artist.
Yeah, yeah.
The Weeknd's an artist.
Yeah.
Entertainer? Wow, this is harder than I thought. Like, name some fucking musicians. I don't know.
I don't listen to music.
That's a lie.
Jamie Foxx is a really good example. I guess Kevin Hart is a good example of an entertainer.
Kevin Hart's an entertainer.
I'm trying to think of music examples, though.
I'll say, like, Justin Bieber is an entertainer.
That's what I was going to say with The Weeknd, because like the more pop music things, and especially like very specifically pop, that's like an entertaining gig.
The reason I say he's an artist is because like he is able to create, like some people just make
an
music.
Aura.
Yeah, but he makes an aura, a universe. There's a new look every album.
No, like older people did that.
Constantly reinvents himself. Prince is an artist. Michael Jackson is definitely an artist and also an entertainer.
But I'm talking about people who had like different chapters to their character. MJ, Prince.
MJ did it like
kind of not artistically.
Not on purpose. His skin was just changing color. If he could have stayed one color.
You had Thriller and then you had fucking older shit.
Yeah. But his style changed with the times in terms of like fashion and shit. Cause he went through fucking, he came up through Motown and went into disco and then fucking when he was popping, rock was popular. So there was a lot of rock influence in his music. And then when he fucking was going out, rap was coming up. So his influence is mainly based on culture. And The Weeknd's just like, I'm going to fucking change my look and my sound because I want more money.
I want more money.
I want more money. But yeah, no, Lady Gaga, definitely an artist. Katy Perry, I would say an entertainer.
Trying really hard to keep afloat.
Yeah. Katy Perry?
I feel like
she's good. I mean, like, okay, she's still fucking big, but she's not like 2012-2011 Katy Perry.
Man, we talked about that on a previous episode.
But she's like, I don't know. I feel like you get to a point where you're okay with not being like the top anymore. Like Lady Gaga's cool with just sitting in Vegas and doing the same show every night for a year. She doesn't need to tour the world anymore. She has a residency, yeah.
Damn, bro, I can see what she's going to look like when she's old and it's not pretty.
Oh, yeah, she's going to look gross.
Her Wikipedia picture right now is...
How old is she?
She's 35.
Really? Really? How long has she been around? She came out like 2009,
2008? Let me see. Oh, she has a wonderful signature.
Remember people used to think she was a man?
No.
I remember that used to be a joke in my middle school. Like, oh, Lady Gaga's a penis. And now that's in.
Years active, 2001 to present, says Wikipedia.
Yeah, but how long has she been famous?
I Kissed a Girl was 08.
I Kissed a Girl. That song dropped at the perfect time.
99, she got a G. She got a GED at age 15.
Who?
Fucking Katy Perry.
Really?
And then she studied Italian opera at the Music Academy of the West in Santa Barbara.
Keep doing that research. We're going to take a break, and I'm going to take a piss. I don't know what to do with it. We have so much money. Peace. Who's this?
Sir. Sir looks like a guy. This might just because he has long locks, but he gives me a hope vibe. Hope vibe, like a nice spirit to hug you.
Did you see that clip? Fucking Sir was on The Breakfast Club. Charlemagne the God was Charlemagne-ing the God and making fun of his name and fucking Sir.
Wasn't having it.
Sir just checked him real quick.
Yeah.
It was pretty funny. He was like, that's my fucking grandmother's name, bro. Some
shit.
What?
Yeah. That's a beautiful name.
Yeah. Pull up that clip. Hey, Bart, pull up that clip, please.
Come on, Bart.
Come on, Bart. Chewing on your mousse under the table, cutie boy.
It's only fucking long shit.
Hail me.
New Dark Racial.
I can play part of it.
Fucking dying on the pod.
You're watching The Breakfast Club.
You're not. You're watching
New Dark Racial.
Oh, yeah, and people just kept giving me a positive, response and shit, so From there, I just decided to put some music out, and that worked out. And from there, I met Dave Free, and just things have been moving ever since.
Now,
man.
You wrote for a lot of people. Who else did you write for?
I wrote for Jill Scott. I've had a chance to work with, like, Anita Baker.
Ooh.
I read that.
Wrote some records for Tyrese on his last project.
Tyrese?
Which Stevie one? Wonder.
Stevie. Oh, Stevie Wonder.
Because he can't write, because
he's
blind. That
was funny, because that wasn't even like I was going to the studio to work with Stevie. He showed up. I was working with Melanie Fiona at the time. Shout out to Melanie.
He seemed like a nice guy.
He's so like, hey, man, write me a song. I can't see shit.
She had a cute little baby. I saw a picture of her.
Yeah, man,
yeah,
she
so
did,
cute.
Man. But Stevie kind of pulled up in the middle of the night. Face. And
he was driven. Though.
Shiny
pulled
ass head.
He pulled, he was driven. Right?
Come on, bro.
Praise. Eyebrows.
Nah, but he showed up and he sat and played for about an hour. And he fell asleep in front of everybody.
I'm dead.
How y'all know he was sleeping?
How you know he was sleeping?
So I stole his wallet.
Everybody don't need a podcast, man.
How do blind people handle money?
Other people?
It's like dollars feel the same.
They do.
Fuck.
Dirty.
You should have seen Charlamagne the God, Forrest Whitaker, making fun of his eye. Really uncomfortable. Really uncomfortable
just
to watch.
He's looking at people, and he's just like has a deep, deep stare.
It's the shock value that people love. It's that fucking.
But he does some good interviews when he's not doing some stupid shit.
When he's not just being on one. Just,
I mean, it's radio shit.
If that is your real name, dude.
I don't think it's Charlamagne the God.
This is brought to you by Nick Cannon Mornings on Power 106 FM.
Bro, you see the billboards enough, you see it a lot. Seven times is when you start to click on it,
dude. So Nick Cannon does all.
Sound like a nigga from the hood who's trying to sound fancy. Call me Sir Dow.
Well, let me tell you this: my grandmother gave me that name.
I don't know. I haven't had Snapchat in a long time.
It's like some family shit, so.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Okay. Well, my grandma gave me that line.
That's the most Charlemagne shit. Oh, okay. Just drinking water. Dude, no one can be Charlemagne like Charlemagne's.
I bet that's the last time Sir will be on that show.
Well, the clip I was looking at, no, because I think Sir needs to be on the radio. Sir, I missed it, but this feels like it was a long time ago. This was a month ago, so maybe not.
Sir Daryl is the name that you're gonna call me then. Let's start there.
Sir Daryl.
Yeah, that name means that you gotta respect me.
Henceforth, my
goddamn name. Right.
Yeah, you can say it with a joke all you want, but at the end of the day, it's my name.
Oh, hello, Sir Daryl. No need for hostility.
He said
hello, Sir Daryl.
And then fucking gave him a dap, dude. Oh, dude.
Yeah.
Dude, you know what I do respect about the Charlamagne shit? Is that he plows through it.
That's because he knows not a lot of people can beat him up.
He's on TV.
He's like fucking, first of all, he's not a small guy.
Is he big?
He's a pretty big guy. So there's a lot of confidence that comes from that.
Oh, shit. He just plows through it with a high-pitched voice and a smile.
It's good to meet you, brother. How you doing?
I'm good. Okay. We met each other before?
We have.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. I guess last time I wasn't that nigga.
Yes,
but,
sir.
You know.
No, you weren't. You were poor.
Sir seems nice. I like Sir. You know it's a good Sir song?
What?
You know what it is.
I don't listen to Sir.
Never listen to a fucking great ballad that is this song right here?
New Dark Racial.
I've been going silly for the west side.
West side.
You might catch me rolling where the breath's right. Ain't no opposition, I'm the best ride. I'm gonna take my city on a test ride.
New Dark Racial.
This is a banger.
You don't wanna see me on a bad day.
Sir.
I was just a nigga with some moon dreams. Now
if that is your real name.
Third trimester, dark racial humor.
Excuse me, sir.
Most award-winning podcast on the history of the earth.
That's right.
Fuck yourself.
You're listening
Jake
to it.
Mirror. You hear that, Jack and Nick? Suck a cock.
Yes.
Button.
Jack and Nick.
Fucking
Joe
Maul.
Button with Rory and Maul.
Parks.
If that is your real name.
Can't forget about Parks and Sign Man.
Yes.
fuckers. You ain't shit.
We're potting right now.
You pot hard. I'll pull up to you motherfuckers at the potties.
Kamala Harris dropped out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No one liked her. She was a fucking cop.
She was a cop trying a little too hard to be the Obama.
Yeah. No
it's
one
just
liked
like,
it.
Dude, we already got an Obama, dude. Like, you don't got to pull that shit again, dude.
Like, she's probably, she was like, her team was probably like, all right, so you know Michelle, right?
Yeah.
Try to Michelle it up.
Try to just, hey, remind everybody that you're black and you're a woman.
She didn't campaign good.
Are you familiar with a YouTuber named Lily Singh?
Mm-hmm.
She has a show. She was given a show,
mm-hmm.
a late night show. Gave it a watch.
Yeah.
Every 5 seconds, the woman reminds the audience, the fake audience with the fake laugh track, that she is not a white man.
Yeah. You gotta make sure people know.
I'm just like, dude. Like, how about you tell a joke? Like, it's not.
Does she have a band?
It's not a big deal. I don't know. I just watched some YouTube clips. But it was just like, dude. It's not a big deal. Like, Oprah hasn't been on the fucking TV for 30 years. Like,
for real.
Honestly, it's just, why don't you just do your job?
Young people.
It's I don't know. It's a disaster. She should just, like, some YouTubers just need to stay on YouTube.
Hold up. A little late with Lily Singh, headline of YouTube clip, Snoop Dogg reveals how he coined the word chronic.
Well, I want to hear this because I didn't know he coined that.
Chatted backstage. I didn't mention this to you, but we've actually met before.
What was it?
Yeah.
Hold on. How old is she?
So,
I think she's like 30.
It was at a YouTube event I was hosting. I believe you were DJing. You were on stage. And here's the thing, though. You were passing out joints to all the YouTube executives from the stage.
39.
Do you remember?
Okay, now you just sparked a flame. Oh, now I remember.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
And here's the thing. It made my night very interesting because
all the high
YouTube execs kept coming to me to start conversation. So there's a lineup of nonsensical things happening all because, and right behind, I kept seeing you being like, here you go for you, and you're not like, Snoop, you're killing me here.
Yeah, but you know, that's what I'm about. I'm
damn, that is not a full audience.
It's also not a great story.
Enjoying himself.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? The entertainer that loves to entertain.
You hear that? You're all going home. Was it okay?
Her voice is very distinctly raspy.
This show also doesn't come on to like 1:30 in the morning.
It says a little late.
When was the first time you ever smoked some really, really good weed?
Probably the first time you ever smoked.
Early 90s, I was in the Poly Apartments on the east side of Long Beach. And it was some white guys that came by, and they had some weed called hydroponic. And it was so good, we just started saying, man, this hydroponic is... God, it's hydroponic. And the white boy was trying to tell us, that ain't the name of it, but we was like, and then long story short, we trying to change the name of Ponic to Chronic, and that became Dr. Dre's hit album and the whole nine.
We were just caught up in it all, dude.
It's great.
This is a 5-minute clip, and it could have ended right about there.
It's great to hear some weed history. You think Snoop Dogg's ever like, hey, I just want to do an interview where we don't talk about weed. Is that possible? I know I fucking smell of marijuana.
I mean,
can we just talk about the music? Maybe some of the charity work I do on the side? It's not all about weed, you know?
I have a football team for fucking high school.
Literally, I have a show.
Does he?
He used to have a show where he, like, coached football. But it was, like, on AOL or some bullshit. So no one watched it, of course.
Let's see if I type in Snoop Dogg on YouTube right now. What's the first thing?
Snoop Dogg doesn't even do anything. He's just famous for being Snoop.
4 months ago, song with Swizz Beatz.
Swizzy Beatz, dude.
A little late.
A little unfunny with Lily Singh. Okay. Cool.
A little trying, a little hard. You really got to just... You're a naturally funny chick. Lil.
Yeah.
Just be you.
Just don't try to copy the format of every other late night show because
every other white dude.
Honestly, a little dated itself.
Super.
It's like, hey, okay,
a funny anecdote.
monologue, then three celebrities, then musical guest, and then the next day, monologue, okay, three
so
celebrities,
how do you change
guest.
A talk show? A TV talk show.
A TV talk show.
Because Fallon did a bunch of games.
Fallon is like...
He did a lot more games, less politics.
Yeah. Is Fallon talking about politics? If it's anti-Trump, he does.
Probably, but
has
I think
to, it's Hollywood.
He shies away from the politics. Colbert is all about the politics.
Colbert is all about the politics. Fucking what's that guy's name? Jimmy Kimmel's super politicky lately.
I don't think fucking Fallon does politics stuff.
Fallon, whenever there's like a major event, like a State of the Union, he has to cover it because everyone's talking about it.
Jimmy Fallon.
Colbert, dude, Colbert is just too much for me, dude. It's just like, bro. People have a long day. They want to come home, and the last thing they want to talk about is politics.
That's not true for a lot of people, man.
Really? Because that's the thing. So many people tell me this about sports. They're like, dude, I just want to watch football. I don't give a shit about this political stuff.
Some people, politics is their sports. It's their fucking getaway, dude.
If you like politics, though.
Yeah.
But if you're watching late night for fucking comedy, like, don't you just want to just watch comedy?
They're fed what they're fed, bro.
Nothing makes me change the channel faster now than just...
You're
like,
also not the masses.
Yeah, but I don't know. Well, you can't say for sure. You don't know.
If you're the masses?
No, what people prefer. If people prefer the political banter of late night hosts or not.
They watch it.
Maybe they just want to...
They watch what they want to watch.
Maybe they just want to hear Kirsten Stewart talk about her cat.
Mm.
Talk about how she made a pie. The Weeknd was on Colbert today. Speaking of that.
Oh, fuck.
He got mobbed.
Yeah?
Yeah, there's a clip of him just getting fucking just a sea of people swallowing poor Abel.
Weeknd.
It was crazy.
On Fallon?
No, on Colbert. I don't think it's out yet. They taped it today. It's probably not up yet.
Oh, yeah. Here's the TMZ 9 hours ago.
Choo-choo-choo. It's funny how they like film that shit in the morning.
He said "choo choo choo."
Choo choo choo. You automatically knew what it was.
Oh fuck!
TMZ.
Nice, dude.
Choo choo choo. That's what we need for DRH. DRH. I guess we gotta have that new dark racial, but.
New dark racial.
But they have sounds.
Choo choo choo. I'm sad because my favorite guy from TMZ got fired.
Which one?
The black guy. He was like the big black guy, the one without the dreadlocks. And he usually talked the most because he
was taller.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. I liked him.
And
I don't watch TMZ like that.
Apparently he fucking he was getting into an argument on the air with someone and then like he was like, hey,
they really
man.
Do that shit live, huh?
Yeah, he's like, man, hey man, I'm gonna fuck you up if you embarrass me like that. That's grounds for losing your job.
You gotta have your boundaries, man.
Yeah, so yikes.
Let's play some clips. I'm not going to get... you heard it. I was trying to mute it. Oh, that's a dope fucking jacket, Abel. Oh, God, Abel. Oh, Abel. Oh, jeez. Oh, Abel. Okay, it's a lot of people behind a barrier. He's not getting mobbed yet.
And then the floodgates open.
Signing a bunch of girls. Abel.
What do you even think...
Oh, shit.
In that situation.
There they go.
Who do you trust?
Your bodyguard that you pay?
Who do you, like, you don't know if your friends are your friends. You don't know if your mom loves you for you anymore.
People are crazy. Shit. Okay. You're behind a barrier.
Yes.
It goes down. People are running. Do you run?
It's the fucking weekend. Of course. I don't care if he's 5'4". I'm going to tackle that motherfucker. He owes me.
See, there's a dude in the back that's just really behind it all with his phone out, and that's me.
Oh, God.
He owes me. I'm going to get him to sign this shit.
That's crazy.
There he is.
Poor wonder dude. When this, like...
It's gradual. It doesn't happen in, like, one time.
Unless you're Lil Nas X. I wonder when this, like, culture of celebrity started.
Of mobbing?
Of mobbing. Did it start with Hollywood?
Beatles?
But before that, Elvis? Elvis before
Elvis.
Beatles? Who was a big musical star before that? Chuck Berry?
Yeah.
I don't know if he got mobbed, but...
I don't know.
Interesting.
I don't know.
I wonder if it got like. You ever watch Beatles clips of them getting fucking fucked up by fans? It looks the same.
Yeah.
Except no one's holding phones.
Yeah. Just newspapers flashing
back and forth. I'm just like, dude.
Like, maybe it started with video.
Maybe.
As soon as there's video, people see it.
Or when fucking paparazzi started. When did that start?
I feel like it's just once you have a big star. But I think media helps it a lot.
Has to be.
Because then you see other people doing it and you get that social currency.
Yeah.
I bet media helps.
I wonder what it's like to be a paparazzo.
It's probably a little dirty.
Probably really just a lot of waiting around.
Yeah.
Probably just being a scumbag for a living.
I'm sure there's a little bit of cordial work relationship between Papo and celeb.
Because you kind of got to, what's the word I'm looking for? You got to poke at them to get them to do what you want. Hey, what'd you think of this? What'd you do about this? Huh? Are you and so-and-so getting back together?
It's not going to come. There's a thing where if you're trying to remember something and you don't remember it right away.
Provoking.
Yeah. Unless you talk about something else, then it doesn't really do it.
Yeah. So some people are like, I used to feel bad for Justin Bieber because motherfuckers be like, hey, motherfucker. Hey, yo, your parents got divorced. Yeah, I'm fucking your girlfriend. Like, and then he would just get mad and then they take pictures of him and then they go get TMZ and make 10 grand. It's like, bro, that sucks.
Entertainment, I guess.
Entertainment. Would I trade this life for that?
Yeah.
Sure, why not? Fuck it.
I mean,
it's probably fun. Probably gets boring real quick, but, you know.
It's the same. The grass is always greener, you know?
Grass is always greener. Does he wish he could just go to a fucking movie with his girlfriend?
Yeah.
Like a normal person?
I'm
probably.
I'm sure when he was homeless, he wanted something like this.
Who, The Weeknd?
Yeah.
Who knows what he wanted? Probably just wanted a hot meal.
Coke.
Probably just wanted to fuck a white bitch strung out on heroin.
Just live in Canada.
Yeah. Just live through another Canadian winter.
Jesus Christ.
I know.
A fucking homeless coke addict in Canada.
That's really some rags to riches shit. It's like.
It's almost too good?
It's almost like it was a narrative created to promote the artist.
I mean, the character always mimics the story, so I'm sure there's some realness there, but I'm sure it also helps the character as well.
Yeah, it's like fucking man's really dropped out of high school.
Did he?
Yeah, and then it was just like, I'm going to be homeless and make music downtown. What if he sucked at it? He'd be dead.
I'm sure a lot of people do that.
So don't do that unless you have the voice of an angel. Please.
Find River. He's in range. He shoots in time. Bingo! Clippers basketball is exploding, and you can see it happen right here.
G-Men 74, Patriots 2.
Lay down your money.
The New York football Giants once and again and forever.
It's sports time.
New Dark Racial.
Everybody don't need a podcast.
What's going on there?
Dude, a little bit. Of the same old, same old. Of course, we're not looking at the East because who gives a fuck?
How about that West?
The Suns are the 8th. The Warriors, let's see if they're still the worst in basketball. Still the worst in basketball. Clippers are 3rd. A game and a half behind 2nd place. No, a half game behind 2nd place. The Nuggets are in 2nd. And Los Angeles Lakers are 1st.
Yikes, we gotta do something about that, boys.
I'm finna fucking break LeBron's leg.
Christmas is our time to shine.
Christmas games, dude. I said it before, I'll say it again. Christmas basketball is the best basketball.
Jesus Christ himself will be in attendance at the game. Courtside, because you know he's everywhere.
He sees it every year.
He knows he's gonna win.
And he sees you when you're sleeping.
And he still comes to the game.
The Warriors are still scheduled for a Christmas game because they were the best team. We're looking at Celtics, Raptors, kind of lame. Rockets, Warriors is going to be lame. Clippers, Lakers at 5 p.m.
Imagine and, you're just like LeBron's kid. You're just like, oh, daddy has to go to work on Christmas.
He's a high school basketball player. But also not as good as his father, and he's getting so much media, they're basically just fucking him as a person.
That must suck. Or it's probably boosting the fuck out of his ego. He's getting more girls than ever.
Yeah, but I don't think he's that good.
You don't? For a high school player, is he good?
That's what I'm saying. I'm pretty sure he's not that good.
Not NBA material yet? Or ever?
I don't really know. I haven't watched this shit. I'll ask the homie if he's good.
Is he going to college?
I don't know. I bet his father wants him to go to college.
Gonna destroy.
You want to bet where he goes to college?
In college. Anywhere.
UCLA?
Fuck it. If I were him, I'd go to a school that's fun.
Not UCLA?
UCLA? Bro, Westwood has two bars in it, dude. Barney's and Malcolm's.
New Dark Racial.
If I were him, I don't know a lot about like college the basketball. Most fun schools, but
Arizona was.
I would fucking go to Arizona.
Yeah.
If I was LeBron's son, he'll probably be like, "Oh, I'm going to Arizona." Then he goes to Tucson. He's like, "Never mind." Yeah.
Tucson's fun, bro.
Dude, girls are just gonna line up just to fuck just LeBron's
trying
son.
Trying to get pregnant. Oh.
Oh. Those winning jeans.
Their loins are just like, they can smell it.
You know that kid's probably like 7 feet tall, right?
He's probably going to be tall. Sharif O'Neal was about to go to U of A, but he went to UCLA, I think.
His dad's like, I don't want you up to a four. I need you to find a nice Asian girl.
Nice Asian girl.
A nice Asian or Indian girl at UCLA.
Right, he was born in 2000, and he's 19.
Wow, I feel old. I feel old.
I was born in 1996. That's not that far away from 2000.
I was born in 95.
Ew. 96 is the place to be. Is fucking Sharif 7? Oh, no. He's 6'9". He's only 6'9".
Wow, he's not getting any pussy. Right, Bart?
7 or above, fuckers.
Bart, the moose is dead. Let it go. All right, guys, we're going to wrap it the fuck up.
New Dark Racial.
We'll catch you guys after the weekend.
This is Dobie House with Dark Racial Humor.
Everybody have a good one.
Enjoy it.
Thank you.
Bye.
For listening. Bye.